getting me back here. Man, you won't believe what I've been here for the last month and a half. I want to tell you what. It's been really rough out there on the road, but I'm telling you what, we're here tonight at the Vision Federal Credit Union Studios at 401 Penn Street. We're back bigger than ever. And I got to tell you, I got a show in store for you tonight, folks. This is going to be a good one. Our topic tonight, as you can see, is going to be our local tens of the pretzels and the chip factory. Oh, you got to pardon me. Why am I wearing this bulletproof? Well, it's not really a bulletproof vest. It won't stop a bullet, but it'll slow it down a little bit. This is one of these old flak jackets. Now, you may wonder, where the heck have I been lately? Well, I had all my neighbors get these Russians out of their yard. So things have been a little tight there, and you know, I've been out on the road. Wait till you see what I got store for you next month. I got film footage of being out on the road, and man, I got some places that when you see what I went through, you will not believe what time I had. So I want to welcome you tonight, folks. My name is Jon Showers. I'm your producer and the host here at the Pennsylvania Pickers at the BCTV Studios and the Vision Federal Credit Union Studios at 401 Penn Street. We have fans driving by. We have to, hey, can you see that over on the university bus that's right in front of our studio? This is what it's all about, folks. Education. Education you cannot get enough of. And I got to thank these folks for backing me with doing this show. This is our version, which is a better version of what the Pickers that you've seen on TV was. See, in this case, we don't have the reality stuff. Well, on the road, I kind of did, but here we don't. What we're doing is we're educating you on a different topic each month on what the collectible and the antique industry bears. And people collect all types of things. And you see, I got a few other little things thrown in here that, you know, I'm going to throw a little mix into it. I do have to apologize, though. Two of the most important tins out of my collection I wanted to bring, which is the very first Tom Sturgis that was on the 200 block of Mulberry, and the second one that they made. They're two of the rarest ones ever. I don't know if we got the Charlie Chip guy. We're going to get to these in a second, but if you flash down here, we see the Tom Sturgis cans. This is a Reading icon. And a lot of these companies, what they did is they went door to door. Why not? We're going to touch on that in a minute. So let me get going on the show here. Hey, and I got to tell you, we got to show this out. We're Muhlenberg proud tonight. Huh? Muhlenberg Mules, Muhlenberg Township. They rock. So let me get rid of this here. It's a little heavy having it on. Although it's Reading, maybe I should keep it on because I'm wearing a wire. And you don't want to wear a wire in Reading. But anyway, let me throw this aside. Hey, I got to share this with you guys. Part of my travels, and I told these guys I'd hold this up. This is part of Pennsylvania. I ended up in M. Lenton, Pennsylvania. Now, you may never have heard of M. Lenton, and you see the guy in the background? Where's Ray? That's the title of our show tonight. Where's Ray? M. Lenton is home to Pennsylvania's Bigfoot. Can you believe we have our own Bigfoot here in Pennsylvania? And I'm working on another little sideshow. I'm going to give him my program director, John, for the year about. We're going to try something maybe to throw in the mix this summer called Line Busters. Now, what Line Busters is, man, I didn't realize this. Pennsylvania is home to some of the best fishing in the world. And some of these things, like the state record that was caught out of this place where I was up by, this thing was 83 inches long. Can you imagine a fish 83 inches long? It's almost as long as, if not longer, than this beautiful desk that they got us here from Vision Federal Credit Union. Man, I like these guys. They got this stuff going on. So anyway, this is episode 21 tonight, and I want to welcome everybody back. We tried to do one last month. I did film footage. We're going to roll that into the mix for next month on that show. And wait till you see where the military show is going to come to you from. That's right. That's right. What better place than to go to Poland? And from Poland, we're going to go to the Ukraine. Never mind the Reading Airport Air Show. We're going to take reenacting to the next level, the real level. So I want you guys to see what other parts of the world are like so that you understand what we do have here in Reading, PA. And this is loaded with history, this part of the block. I love this part of Reading. It's so, man, to look out here in the daylight, and it seems like January we're here with that other guy. Where does that guy go? Oh, the guy's out metal detecting. I think he's trying to find a pipeline or something. I don't know what he's doing. But anyway, I wish him the best of luck. We don't wish anybody any harm. Same as our ex-partners down there at Redingers. We wish them the best of luck, too. I do got to tell everybody, what we have coming up is extravaganza next month. And please, one of the best places you want to check out is Shupp's Grove. Marilyn down at Shupp's Grove, she's been preparing all season, and she's got a good place down there, and she's looking forward to opening up. It's outdoors. You ain't got to worry about, you know, diseases, masks, and all that kind of stuff at her place. She runs a top-notch operation. So my hat's off to Marilyn out there, and I'll be talking to you soon, Marilyn. She's like a sister to me. I work for her. I sell there. You may see me there from time to time, but we're going to get on our subject here in a very short time. I do have to mention some names tonight, or shout outs, I'll be brief. I would not be here if it would not be for Brandon. Now, Brandon, I gotta just mention this guy, because this guy, I tried getting him on the show. He's a little camera shy, maybe I'll get him on in the future, but down here he's got some deer antlers. And what Brandon does is he collects deer. What he's got is he's got a deer sanctuary that he takes care of these things every day meticulously, keeps them safe from harm. And you know what? You people out there don't wanna go hunting. Hey, if you wanna hunt, hunt. But let me tell you what, when you're hunting something and something's hunting you, it's a different story, buddy. It's a real different story. And these people over in Ukraine, what they're going through right now, you ain't got a clue. What we have is a comfort zone. Don't be surprised if that ain't gonna happen here tomorrow, because it could, very well could. Anyway, our production staff I wanna mention tonight. I got Jordan in the control room, and I got DJ here's my cameraman. I worked with these guys many episodes. Jordan, I think, through all 21 episodes. And I wouldn't be able to do this without these guys. As well as BCTV, Heather, you're the boss lady, and I told you, I make you proud, and I always will. As well as John Fedora, my program director. Even though I've never met him, my program director is the best guy in the world. Man, what I had going on out in the road, he said, just get footage of it. We'll put it together for next month's show. I'm like, but John, this is not really fun. But at one point, I was like the Blair Witch. I'm going to die. Get me out of here. I'm telling you, being in a van on the side of the highway with a bad fuel pump, what an experience. But that's another episode. Anyway, Brandon, I got to tell you, man, this guy took care of my cats. He took care of the fort while I was gone. And that means a lot to me, man, because I won't be able to get home tonight without this guy. My vehicle still broke down. I got to still put cars together to do all this. So, hey, Ben, what are you going to do? It's the way it is. You know, somebody's got to fix it. If you can't do it, you got to fix it. So, and we didn't do our beginning part. I got to finish the shout-outs, and we'll do that. Vanessa, I've owned this girl a shout-out for several times now. I got to tell you, man, if I were ever to give my heart to anybody, I'd give it to Vanessa, because this girl's got a heart of gold, and she works so hard. She's raising two kids by herself, and Vanessa, man, I mean, this person, I mean, she's been there when my Max died. I mean, she's a friend that's the best friend that you could ever have, you know, and I'm telling you, people like Vanessa and Brandon, that's the type of people you want to surround yourself with, folks. People that put you down and don't want to hurt you, you don't want to be around people like that. The people that help you and support you, that's your real true friends in life. Andrew, and I got to mention Darnell. Darnell, you know I love your Speedway. You keep me going, guy. I mean, come on, how much? I paid for one of your salaries probably there or whatever. Now, I do got to share with you guys, there was a Speedway associate, and I got his little obituary here. I had Vanessa print this out for me. Chris Hoover. When I heard this happened on the day that I left. And Chris was a former ACW wrestler. He was 51 years of age from Richmond, PA. Man, my heart bleeds and goes out to the family for this, because Chris, he was a big guy, but he had the biggest heart. And he loved heavy metal. He was the Mad Butcher. And I mean, if you'd seen this guy back in the day, he was blood coming out of everything. This guy come down on you. Man, I'm telling you, this guy had a heart of gold. And it's going to be a sad thing to not see his face in there in the morning, every morning. And Gina, hope to see you soon. I mean, I haven't seen you in a while, but hope everything's going good with Gina. She's my old pal from going back to the days of growing up in Reading. So some obituary mentionings there. Now, I do got to mention these folks. Now, where I was in Hamilton, PA, I did stop through there because it's coming up on a show I want to do. You know, we had this National Christmas Center nearby here. Well, that was sold off. The guy that bought it, he's putting some of it together. He's selling off most of it. I've got some friends that have been the best customers for Vintage Christmas from me, Michael Gallagher and Lindsay. And I got to tell you, I was at their place out there, and man, that room I sat in that night, like, all night long, 71 Santa Claus was staring at me. And I don't even like Christmas, but I'm telling you what, I didn't sleep a wink that night. So I want to do some film footage in their Christmas museum that they have out there. What's different about theirs versus the one on Route 30 is that they cater to everybody. They don't selectively say, we don't like these types of people, we don't like those people. They cater to everybody. And that's important in this day and age. Because I don't care what your sex gender is, I don't care what your sexual preference is, I don't care what you're doing as long as you don't hurt animals, kids, or women. That's it. You'd be the right thing, you'd be a mentor. You know, and we're in a day and age that, you know what, people, this is why it's America. This is what these people are fighting for overseas, and we're not even half-heartedly supporting because of this, well, it's another story. Brad Rapp at this town of Edmonton, I got to share with you this. This little place where I was at in Stoutsburg, Marion Township, I've been in an argument with these people. Since 1985, they're collecting federal money for a national historic district. They haven't given any citizens any tax break. They haven't given out any grants for the work they've done in their places. All they've done is taken this money. Well, this town of Emlenton, where this Bigfoot thing was, same size town, exactly. Exact same population. But what they did different was, man, they had, this is the area where they first discovered oil in Pennsylvania. They had the Pumping Jack Museum. They had a boys club, just like the Olivets that I went to in Reading. And man, I talked to him in there and said, hey, I'd like to come in and teach some of you guys some karate when I'm up here working on Michael and M's museum. I'm going to go back and help these guys and put their museum together where they're moving to a newer location and try to get them in. But also a fellow by the name of Bruce. Now, Bruce got this AMC dealership that, man, when I seen this Mark Donahue car, if you guys out there know about cars, you know about Mark Donahue. He won the Indy 500. But this was a Mark Donahue AMX. Very rare car. V8 engine in it. They did change the color a little bit, but the door jams are the same color. So I want to get back there and film that. And he's got a train display that's got the Reading Railroad set up and everything that it blew my mind. So we're going to mix that in the next couple shows. But we got to do this. I had to do that on my books, and I don't do it on the desk. You can pick your friends, you can pick your nose, but you better be picking the best seat in the house. Because this is prime time from downtown Reading, PA, 401 Penn Street. This is the Pennsylvania Pickers. And I'm telling you, I mean business at this business. I'm not here to take your money. I'm here to educate you as to what your money and what your value is. Maybe your uncle dies. Hey, this guy didn't leave me no money. Well, let me tell you what I got sitting here, this is where your money is. So, tonight's subject of the tens, I want to get on to those tens. Now, as you see over here, and I'm going to have DJ here working a camera on me a little bit, and I can move around. You know, because you know what? This is genuine, straight from the heart. So let me spin around out here so I can show you some of this stuff. We're going to start off over on this side. Now, what happened was, at one point in American history, the goods that we were getting and we were eating, they put them in these tins to protect them. Now, what Charlie Chip did, and this is a Reading icon, and you can see I got quite a bit of these things because these things are gold. Even the younger generation today is liking on collecting these things. If you were growing up in Reading, guaranteed that your parents or your grandparents would have either Charles Pretzels, or they may have a Charles Chips, or they may have the bigger pretzel and chip can. Now what they did was, this company was genuine. I know them as being on Mall Street behind where the old 10th of Green Elementary School was, and what they would do is they had a guy that went around, and for $5 he would fill up your chip can. This is actually the pretzel can. They sold the pretzels, they sold the chips. Now this seemed to be a thing in Reading that was very popular, both the chips and the pretzels. I never really realized this. Today there's KC Auto Body. Hey, I remember you, KC. And what they did was, we were famous for this in this area, but unless you leave this area, you're not really aware of this. And I realized this once I did leave the area, and as I started collecting this stuff over the years, besides the lunch boxes like you see back here, like the Hot Wheels, the Fonz, hey, gotta say that to them. But when we would go by there riding bicycles, they'd give us a little baggie one day if they had pretzels they were making, or another day they'd give us chips. And as kids, that was kind of a neat thing. So you know how to time that. But they also did this. At the holidays, this was the holiday shortbread can. And as you can see what these tins were back there, and I'll show you, what they started doing is you kept other things in them. If you had half a loaf of Mayer bread, you wrapped it up, put it in there if you didn't have a bread box. And what this did is, this kept the moisture, kept the things in your kitchen, the elements or whatever for getting in there and making it stale or whatnot. Oh, never mind that guy. Hey, this guy's down in D.C. Remember him? Yeah, him and his son. This is an interesting one. This is out of my collection. Now, other items started coming into the household. To give you an idea price value-wise, jumping back to Charlie's a little bit, on the average, this is the one you want to find. You find the Charlie cookies or the Holly Bread ones, these are rare. Now, I picked this up from Jubilee, got to give them a plug out, at one of their stores down here in Lebanon County, and I recently got this beautiful Charlie chip can. This is a mid-century. On an average, what the values of these are, the bigger one's about $22 to $30, depending on what it is. Now, they also had these in other various parts of the country, so that's why you had different varieties, the different color variations. There's so many of these out there that it's a collectible feel. Now, this is a rare one that I had come across. We'll get this up here so Jordan can see. This is Bosco. Bosco coffee. All right. Now, this has got beans in it, but it's planting beans. This is about $150 tin. And I didn't try to clean it up. If you try to clean any of these up, you want to use a damp cloth. You don't want to use chemical abrasives at all, because this stuff was printed on these tins, and that's going to damage them. This guy here, I just picked up out by Myerstown. Our flag's coming down. Unless we got the yellow flag there from old Reading Fairgrounds days or Lincoln Speed, whatever. This is Billy Myers. So Reading, Pennsylvania also. And right there it says it, Billy's Pretzels, Reading, PA. And you can see by the age of this was near a stove somewhere, whatever. Now, I did try to bring some of the color back to show you guys on the show. And I got to apologize. Next month, I'll bring the two of the Tom Sturgis that are the rare ones. This guy right here, this is going to bring a little bit more money. It's worth about $35 to $40. What they started doing, candies. Candies started coming in these things. Now, these are part of the collectible thing. Being part of the Pennsylvania Dutch era, you can see this had butter cookies. And let's see who this company was. Valley Brook Farms. This is out of New Jersey. But notice it's got the Pennsylvania theme on there. Kind of neat thing that they went after. Ritz Crackers. Now, as you know, these came in a cardboard box. But what they did, Ritz got smart, and they made one of these tins. So once you open up the box, you can put the others in there. And this is a limited edition one. It's out of my collection also, and it's in pretty good shape. These are going to bring about $10 to $15. Smaller ones like that, they could go up higher. Here's another one. This is Old South Candies. Reading, Pennsylvania. Division of Ludens. This is right over here by 8th Street. This was the Old South Hard Candy Dannies. And this, again, this is a local little Reading thing. Here's some of these antlers. I got to show you these. These are off of Brandon's deer. Now, these are deer that are raised in captivity, okay, that are cared for professionally by a person who cares. They're not out there blasting them. Look at the size of that horn. Can you imagine that thing? He had these in his truck. I said, yeah, I like to put them on the show. Then he's got one of his dad's Vietnam ammo cans here. Here's another one. Whoop. See that? We're normal guys. We make mistakes. This is what I'll get to in a second here. So here we've got Tom Sturgis pretzels, twin pack, the little ones. And you see what they started doing is different themes. Here we got like a springtime theme going on it. These guys, look and finding them is hard because most people don't go for these. They go for the advertisement ones on it. I go for anything that has the markings of these companies. And I got to mention this one. For those of you that don't know Geno's, you got chicken in this bucket. And Geno's was in the Reading area. One on Fifth Street Highway, they had one down at Perkiomen Avenue. And what happened was you got chicken in this bucket. This guy was a Reading Eagle, or a Philadelphia Eagle football player that he got sued by none other than the Kentucky guy. And this guy had the same recipe. So who was the right one here? This was the hometown hero. And again, not many of these survived. They had all kinds of promotional items as well. During the wartime efforts, you went to OD Green Cans. Imagine that. Doesn't have a company name on it. Now, this would have been what they may have shipped goods over for the soldiers down, whether it's chips, pretzels, or whatever. And we got a bigger one there. We'll show you that. These guys, if you find them, they're going to average about $20 to $30 each. Tommy Dale potato chips. Tuckered in Pennsylvania. Reading, PA again. So as you see, what do we got going on here? Oh, this one. If you come across this guy, and I don't have the lid to it, this Victor Sturgis one, this is about a $75 can now. Now you see what somebody did. They wrote cake flour on this. So they didn't just use these for what they were doing for chips or for pretzels. These guys are bringing about $30 to $35. The two rare ones I got, Tom Sturgis wanted them from their museum, and I said, no, I can't part with them. They're just too rare for me. You know, it's just part of what I like to collect. This one I got to mention to you guys. And this is a friend. This was also a serving tray. This is a holiday can by Quinlan Pretzels. My shout out to Becky Donahue Weiser. This is her aunt. This was the first businesswoman in Reading, PA. Her brother had the chips. The daughter had, the sister had the Quinlan Pretzels. And this right there again, Quinlan Reading, PA. I don't know if you can see that. We'll get that up there. This is one of my favorite cans. Look at that. Reading, PA, and it was also a serving tray. This was around 1910, 1920 area. This bad boy is worth some money. Everybody's got these things on the side of your house, the stars. I got $30 on this one. So anybody's interested in that one, give a shout out here to the studio or whatever, but it's been a hard sell here lately. And got to mention this. Adamstown, Pennsylvania, Good's potato chips. Leesport, Pennsylvania, Good's potato chips. We got Utz potato chips, they're Hanover. Then we got Mannheim, Stamen's. But I had to bring this. How many people know that we had a beverage called Birdsboro soda, made right here in Birdsboro, Pennsylvania? And I want to shout out to a gal that I was helping on some stuff for her house. She was rebuilding a mansion down there. You guys come out there, come across any of these glass doorknobs. Let me tell you what, these bad boys here, some of these are $30 each. So you got to watch out there when you go looking for some of this stuff. And I want to do a show coming up. There's people that are making things out of these insulators. And I'm going to do a show specifically on that. You got to use a diamond drill bit to drill into them, but they're making chandeliers that they end up bringing about $3,000 and up, depending on what they are. But we also had Kutztown quality beverages sodas. So you see what we got going on here. In our area here, not only did you have the stuff that when you had the munchies, you wanted something to chase it down with, you had a soda from around here. You know what I mean? We got Kutztown beverages, we got Birdsboro, and we can't forget an original A-Treat. That's one of my favorites, is A-Treat to this day. I've always been hooked on the A-Treat cream soda, the white birch beer, man, that's one of my favorite ones. That's a pretty good one there. Hey, I got to mention this. Something I'm going to be working on. There was a little Swiss house up on the hill, up on Mount Penn. Now, Michelle Napolitano Lynch, I got something to show you up there on that place. Did you ever realize how they built these houses? That's what I need to show you, Michelle. So I brought this along as a little souvenir that I kind of picked up. Coming back from the old country, you know, getting these Russians out of this guy's backyard. Hey, we need the help. Anybody want to join me? Let's do this. I want to give a shout out. Anybody that wants to go on a little Boscov vacation package, let's go to Poland. You can join me. I'll be your tour guide. We'll see new, interesting, strange, exotic things. And we're going to get to meet a class of people that are no different than us. They're great people. I can't understand what a word they say, but you know what? That's fine. Their women are beautiful. And their people have hearts of gold, just like we do here at Burks TV. And you know what? It's all about education, folks. You notice we're not trying to take money from you or sell you anything. I'm trying to show you what this stuff is worth. You know, we drag this stuff in. Now, when they made this stuff, I got to touch on this one. It's a little beat up. But what did they make this stuff with? They made it with lard. That's right. Lard. Not vegetable oil, because vegetable oil was made for turkeys during World War II. And when it goes in your body, it don't come out. So you don't want to be eating any of that. Butter and lard. Because lard, well, that'll stick to your ribs, but it makes stuff taste good. So I hope you kind of like the little collection here. Here's another lard can. Look at how big this thing. Imagine the hearts that this stopped. So you see, as part of this collectible type thing with these cans, you also have the lard, and we can't forget the beer guys. I don't have any from Reading. Shout out there to Mike Pence, my buddy, but we even had Miller Lite, Miller Genuine Draft. They made a can. My guess was, what you put in here, probably put pretzels underneath your bar. So when you're having a few beers with buddies or whatever, you got the pretzels out. You know, this is a Berks County tradition. And, you know, I've been wanting to touch on a show like this for quite some time. And to be able to do this on this has been fantastic, I think. It's kind of like spreading it out. The trip out onto the road, man, I got to tell you. I'll tell you, that was an adventure of a lifetime. Times I didn't think I was going to make it back. But I promised my friend Coop one thing. The teeth ain't working. Make sure to take your teeth out before you go to bed, folks. So anyway, I want to thank you guys for joining in tonight on the Pennsylvania Picker episode 21. I hope you did enjoy the show a little bit, maybe learned a little bit on some of this stuff. We got some of the other stuff here, like Heather in the back here, my boss, she likes to collect this stuff with me, the Pyrex. So I picked up a couple pieces when I was out on the road. This is a little small, rarer one. This guy's a good one, too. I got this, a Jubilee. And then I got a set of primary bowls to pick up. Somebody was asking me, they said, what was this? This was Barnum & Bailey. And I brought this in because it was in some of the stuff. But as you see, I like to try to mix it up. This guy's bringing about $35. Now, if any of your grandmothers out there, if you come across the brooches, all right, and you can kind of see, what I'm holding here is about $500 worth of stuff. The brooches, what this was made of ivory. Everybody looks for this stuff at flea markets. Here we got it in a cross. I got it in earrings. So all total, here's the cameo necklace is 120. All right, and that's a fair market value. Some of these guys are gonna bring about 250 bucks each. The two brooches with the two earrings at 400 bucks is a fair price. So, oh, and I gotta mention this. We did mention about the Bigfoot. Did anybody know the beautiful Lake Champlain is home to Champ, our own version of Loch Ness Monster? Now, you know, in this day and age, people go, is that real, is it fake? Let me tell you what, I fished on this lake. I didn't get any bites from it, but we're gonna go out there for line busters and see when we get one of them. But that's what the show Line Busters, I'm kind of like trying to throw around and maybe mix in with this a little bit. And don't forget the alligators. They're in Florida. And I got to tell you, the super snakes down there are out of control. We need help there as well. So you want to go on a fun vacation? Why don't you go down here and catch some snakes? Let's go on over to Poland. You know, let's have a good time here at what we're doing in life. And remember this, freedom is not free. What we take for granted every day could be gone in a minute. We don't want to fight anybody. We should have come along long enough in our day and age of human beings that we should have all learned to get along. But what we got out there is an enemy. It's an enemy called communism. And that communism is trying to keep you from doing this type of collecting. They don't believe in this. And you notice I got the UFC, it's as real as it gets. Well, that's because that's right. In life, it is real. And the idea of life is to have fun, to collect things and have family values. Go to church, do whatever you want to do, but you know what? Don't hurt anybody. And I got to tell you, folks, I'm so glad to be back here. Woo. It's been tough being out there on the road, but you know what? This is where you get to realize what we got here in Reading, Pennsylvania is a good thing at Vision Federal Credit Union Studios and BCTV. Because what we're out to do is bring you the best in family education and family value type television. Not prescripted, just straight from my heart. See me out there stumbling a little mistake? It's all part of the show, but you know what? It's all genuine. I don't write down anything. You can see all I had down was, I'll try to get these guys' names, but they won't give me their names. I don't know. I'm wearing this wire. I get a little nervous here. I see somebody getting in a car there, but it's beautiful down here. I want to invite anybody that would like to be on our show. Drop me a line at showersjr.john47@yahoo. If you want to be on the show, and that statue. Well, I was working on that too, but we'll get back to that one. You know, the one from the Moon Knight Indians. I didn't make it quite that far yet, but we're going to get there. But I want to thank you for joining us tonight, folks. I had a blast here again. This is my hometown, and I love being here, being able to do this. We have so many things from Reading here to be thankful for, and I got to tell you, Connie over here in security, she saw us pulling in. I said, hey, relax. We're the Pennsylvania Pickers. You know, we're here to do a good TV show for you tonight. So I want to mention her at Allied Security. She's doing a great job of keeping us safe. I want to thank these guys and my production staff. I want to thank Brandon for getting me home tonight. You know, and I'll be back soon. Be back next month. We're on every third Wednesday of the month, folks, unless otherwise. Weather, indoors, weather permitting. We're going to get out there in the field, mixing up a little bit this year. But I want to thank you again, folks, from my heart, as a producer and a host. And remember, there's more than just deals in Dillsburg. I'll be seeing you soon. Thank you again, and have a good night, folks. Thank you for joining in with us. What do you think, guys?